So, jadi dari dalam video ni, saya akan memberitahu apa yang saya tahu, apa yang saya experience sepanjang masa, sepanjang semester saya tinggal di College Regarding UiTM Campus 1 Semarahan Sarawak. College Regarding ialah college untuk perempuan, okay, asrama perempuan. College Regarding ada 4 blok, 4 bangunan. Okay, blok 1, blok 2, blok 3 dan blok 4. Satu blok dibahagikan 2. Blok 1A, blok 1B, blok 2A, blok 2B dan seterusnya. Okay. Blok 1 dengan blok 4 di College Regarding ialah bilik untuk 2 orang sahaja. Satu bilik 2 orang penghuni sahaja, dan manakala untuk blok 2 dan blok 3 ialah khas untuk bilik 4 orang. Kalau kamu nak tengok macam mana keadaan ataupun layout bilik 4 orang ni, don't forget to check out my previous vlog, okay, on my clearance day, UiTM clearance day 2020. So I'll be putting the link. Okay, dia akan muncul di atas ni atau atas ni, siapa tahu. Okay, jangan lupa tekan nanti, okay. Di situ kamu akan tengok macam mana keadaan college and how the room looks like. Sebenarnya saya ada menerima satu komen on my previous vlog. Dia tanya lah, this girl, dia tanya, adakah campus 1 haunted? Saya expect orang yang tanya soalan ni maybe pelajar baru yang akan memasuki UiTM campus 1 tak lama lagi. Maybe this new intake kan. So far lah, saya bagi tahu kamu, saya dah tinggal situ hampir 4 semester. So far, saya tak ada experience paranormal activities. Saya tak pernah dengar orang bercerita pasal paranormal activities. So, I don't want to talk a lot about it. So, in conclusion, no. Okay, College Regarding tidak haunted. Based on my experience, dia tak haunted, tak ada case. Tak ada case orang hysteria ke? Ada kena rasuk ke? Ataupun ada tengok kelibat-kelibat benda yang tak patut ditengok ke? No. So, yeah. So far, I just want to say that College Regarding is a peaceful college for that particular topic, okay? Tapi sini, ini nasihat saya lah, ha? Saya cuma nak bagi tahu lah. Kalau kamu takut dengan benda macam ni, oh, maybe kamu takut just in case tiba-tiba kamu encounter benda macam ni. I know what I'm about to say is a bit cliche, but it's the truth. I want to tell you just to have faith, okay, and stay strong. Just in case kamu takut, just talk about it with your roommates, or maybe you can consult your warden, okay. Warden sentiasa available, tapi selalunya warden ni dia lecturer juga, warden yang tinggal di sama lecturer. Jadi maybe time kelas tu tak dapat jumpa lah, maybe waktu malam, okay, after office hour boleh jumpa lah kalau nak bercerita pasal benda ni, just in case you encounter this kind of thing. But so far lah, I can assure you, okay, College Regarding, no, you won't experience this kind of thing. Paling-paling pun maybe kawan, prank kawan lah. Jangan risau lah. Biasalah, budak-budak suka prank kawan kan. Those mean jokes lah. So, ini tips, okay, dari saya. Saya dah beritahu ya, berdasarkan experience saya dah tinggal di tingkat 1, tingkat 3, tingkat 4 dan tingkat 5, okay. The best, kalau if you have the chance to choose your room, okay, it would be better if you choose second floor and above, okay, second floor and above. Why not the first floor, okay, why not the first floor? First lah, okay, the first time I stay in the first floor is when semester 1. Apa masalah dia tinggal tingkat 1 ni ya? Okay, this is from my opinion. First, it's panas, okay? Panas and humid and it's stuffy. I don't know why. Even if you open the window and the doors of your room, it is still stuffy and it still feels so hot. There's not enough ventilation, okay? Maybe it's because it is in the lower ground, so there's no wind passing by that level. So yeah, it's panas. kalau nak tinggal di tingkat satu, dia ini masalah besar lah bagi saya. Dia kekurangan tempat menyidai baju. Tempat menyidai baju. Level 1, kayak tempat menyidai baju yang available ialah di dekat bilik mandi. Okay, there's this one space. Tempat ni memang khas untuk menyidai baju, tapi dia kecil. Dia tak cukup lah untuk menampung the whole level. Okay, dalam level tu ada how many rooms? 12 bilik tak silap saya. 12 bilik, dan bayangkan satu level tu ada 12 bilik dan satu bilik ada 4 orang. This is why, okay? This is why kadang-kadang kita masuk bilik orang, mereka sidai baju dalam bilik mereka. Why? Because tak cukup ruang dekat luar. So terpaksa lah mereka sidai dekat dalam bilik. So dia lembab, nanti kadang-kadang berbau juga bilik. Problematic tu. So those are the cons, okay? Kamu tinggal di level 1 if you still want to stay in level 1, so that is your choice. I already warn you. There's one thing I want to say, okay? To yang tinggal di College Regarding, okay? Maybe you're watching this, used to be my jiran, or maybe kawan sama level or sama bangunan college. Kamu orang mesti pernah experience budak-budak cerita ni kan? Pernah kan? Adalah, I don't want to say, this is my opinion, okay? Orang yang masuk uni 18 tahun dan ke atas, okay? Tak boleh kejaga kebersihan tu, huh? Especially perempuan, huh? Pad, your sanitary pad. Saya pernah experience ni, ya. Not only me lah, banyak orang. Ramai orang, kawan-kawan saya sendiri, roommate saya sendiri, jiran saya sendiri. Adalah, biasalah perempuan kalau nak period ni. Please lah, habis cuci tu, buanglah dalam tong sampah. Saya pernah ya, beberapa kali masuk shower room. Ada satu pad ni terlantar di semen shower. And ada satu tempat, ada satu time ni, pad ni, dia dah dibersihkan. Tapi dia tak bersih sangat, okay. So this person letak dia di, there's this one space in shower room, tempat untuk letak sabun. So she put it there and left it just like that. Okay. And that pad is not fully clean, not fully washed. So there's this one point I had enough. I took the courage to pick up that sanitary pad and throw it to the to the rubbish bin myself, and then I took a shower. So I want to say, please lah, jangan cerita guys. Especially yang pakai sinki tu, yang dah habis makan Maggi tu, please lah cuci lah sinki tu, janganlah biarkan sisa-sisa makanan tu tertinggal ke sinki, please. Iya, annoyed lah saya. Come on. Pasal ada juga case yang tak pandai flush toilet. Saya faham lah, kadang-kadang flush tu tak berfungsi. Tapi at least lah, ambil lah baldi, okay? Kumpul air dan siram, okay? Do it manually sebab flush dah hidup. So do it manually. What do you expect lah? If people want to use the toilet and see your poop day. Come on lah. We are girls. What are you doing? Come on. So yeah, that is actually my experience tinggal di UiTM Campus 1. So this is what you should expect, okay, bila tinggal di UiTM Campus 1. So that is all for my video. In this video, I don't know if this information actually helps you, but I hope it does. So if you like this video, don't forget to leave a like, and to those who haven't, don't forget to subscribe, because I'll be making a lot of this kind of video in the future, and your support and your comments and your likes really encourage me to do more contents like this. So that is all for me. Thank you so much for watching, and see you guys in the next video. Bye.